what we did, and I said, we, with the long hat pin, we put it down the back like that, and stuck the tape at the back like that, and then gradually wormed that down. They were longer than that, though. They were about that then, 18 inches at least, and then wormed that down into the earth. And they said the thing was that they could see them, that the fairies were moving when the photographs were taken, but that's because they did it in the breeze.
I'd never even thought of it being a fraud. It was just Elsie and I having a bit of fun. And I can't understand it to this day why people were taken in. They wanted to be taken in. Because people keep often say to me, don't you feel ashamed that you've made all these poor people look fools? They believed in you. But I don't, because they wanted to believe. Look at this photograph. That fairy is all out of drawing. That leg doesn't belong to that fairy. And somebody pointed it out in the newspaper. And one of our dear believers said, well, fairies aren't like humans. They haven't got bodies like we have, or the skeleton and the arms and legs. They sort of put it together with thought. And sometimes it doesn't come out right. We didn't have to tell a lie about it at all, because always somebody came out to justify it.
It was very embarrassing because, I mean, two village kids and a brilliant man like Conan Doyle, but we could only just keep quiet.